ब्रह्मानंदं परम सुगतं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वंद्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षीभूतं भावादीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। I welcome you all with my love and respects. See, to tell you honestly, Himalayas is my life. I can say the whole transformation, the whole process which happened in me, the whole thing happened in Himalayas only. I can say I vow the whole thing to Himalayas. It is Himalayas which did the whole thing. When Krishna says, I am the Himalayas among the Achalas, I think Himalayas can only be experienced. It can't be spoken. It's just like enlightenment. Himalayas is just like enlightenment. You can't speak about it. You can only experience it. And that is the land where this whole inner science is developed, created, the research and development happened, and the final product came out. The whole thing happened in Himalayas only. So that is the first and ultimate inner science laboratory where the great research and development in the field of inner science happened. I think at least last 20,000 years, even though the idiotic Western historians go on repeating, only 4,000 years ago the human society is created. Please understand, I do not mean to disrespect Westerners. I have my tremendous love and respect for my devotees. But these historians, they go on twisting the things and abuse on this great Eastern science and culture. At least last 10,000 years, the research and development in the inner science is happening in this great Himalayas. And you will see how every inch is associated with the divine. In India, every inch is a divine. Every inch is associated with spirituality. Actually, now so many things are coming and standing in the net now. There's a big traffic jam. Everything, every idea is fighting. No, I'll come out first. That's why I'm not able to say anything. I'm just stuck. There is nothing much to tell about Himalayas. It can only be experienced. I always tell people, some born blind man, if somebody is blind from birth, you can't make him understand what he is missing. Same way, if somebody has not seen Himalayas, you can't explain to him what he is missing. If he is born blind, one major dimension of his life is missing. Just like that, if you have not seen Himalayas, one dimension of your consciousness you are missing. The possibility which can happen in you, one dimension of conscious possibility is missing. Anything can be missed by a seeker, but not Himalayas. Anything can be missed by a seeker in his life, but not Himalayas. And this is the great land where from time immemorial, this great inner science is created and the research is done, the development went on and the products came out, and again further research and development on the product happened I can say, if you remove Himalayas, no spirituality on the planet Earth. No spirituality on the planet Earth. But for Himalayas, no inner science on the planet Earth. That is the holy land, place where the whole thing happened. Vedic seers are the only masters. See, the way in which Vedic seers address the disciples, they say, Srinmand Vishwe Amritasya Putra Vedaha Meham Purusham Mahantam. They say, O sons of immortality, I know the truth, I am telling you. They are addressing you as a sons of immortality, not sinners. First time on the planet Earth, the truth to go beyond fear and greed is created on this great land of Himalayas. That's why I tell, this is the one and only spirituality to go beyond the fear and greed. And this whole science started, and the research and development happened and came out as a final product in this great holy land, in this great Jnana Bhumi. It's a land of knowledge. This is the land where this great science is created. The great science which is keeping planet Earth still alive. Understand, if at all this great science did not happen on the planet Earth, be very clear, long before these barbaric politicians would have destroyed the planet Earth, rishis, Vedic rishis, are the first group who created a system in which nobody will be enslaved, neither physically or psychologically or spiritually. The first ever system created to liberate human beings happened on this great Himalayas. On this great Himalayas. That is why I always tell people, a seeker can miss anything in his life, not Himalayas. Not Himalayas. It is too much to miss. It is too much to miss. If you have eyes, you should not miss Himalayas. If you don't have eyes, at least come and have this breeze. You will have something. You will have some energy. Let me tell you just few things. I can't describe completely about this greatness of the Himalayas. I can say few things. It is spiritual incubator. Lakhs and lakhs of enlightened beings have left their body here. Basically, society binds you in these three ways. One is physical, the laws and the social rules and country politician. Second, psychological, feeding you fantasies and dreams and ruling you psychologically, giving you the idea of heroes and keeping you under their control. The so-called cinema, drama, all these artists. The third, the so-called religious figures, giving you fear and greed about the hell and heaven and keeping you under their control. The rishis have created a culture, lifestyle, through which from all these three you will be liberated. From all these three you will be liberated. First time on the planet Earth, a system to liberate human beings in the level of physical, mental and spiritual happened on this great land, on this Jnana Bhumi, on this Himalayas. Whenever a rich man dies, he leaves all his property behind and dies. He can't carry anything. If at all we can carry, nothing would have been there on the planet Earth by now. Everything would have been packed. Everything would have been packed. Nothing will be there. Long before all, everything would have been packed. You can't carry anything. Same way, when an enlightened being dies, he can't carry his tapas. Understand? Tapas also can't be carried. He will leave even his tapas behind. Tapas can't come with you. all the tapas power will leave behind and leave the body. So any enlightened being, when he dies, he leaves all the tapas energy. The Himalayas is the place where lakhs and lakhs of enlightened beings have left their body. Traditionally, all enlightened beings, before they leave the body, they will come here and leave the body. That's a tradition in India. Every enlightened master, when he dies, his body is dropped in Ganga. Understand? His body is dropped in Ganga. You should know this doctor, the Japanese doctor, anyhow, the Japanese doctor did a research. Just by 10-15 minutes of chanting some holy word or a good peaceful word, the quality of water changes. Emoto proves, just 5 minutes, this guy sits and chants the word peace, happiness, immediately the quality of water changes. Understand, in this Ganges, every day millions of people stand and pray. Not one or two, not even lakh, millions. Millions stand and pray. And I can say, how many thousands of enlightened masters' body has been put in the Ganges, I don't know. That is why this whole river is energy. It is not just, please understand, Ganges is not totality of drop of waters. Ganges is not totality of water drops. It has got its own identity, its own independent intelligence. First understand, it responds. It responds. You will see how it responds when we travel. When we travel, you will see how it responds. Ganges, Ganga river, has got its own independent, intelligent identity. So do not think it is just a river. Same way Himalayas. Himalayas is a living energy. Millions of people, millions of enlightened masters have left their body here. So much of energy, so much of power. That is the reason it attracts more and more enlightened masters. The money attracts money, just like that. Energy attracts energy. This place is filled with energy. Its energy and its very existence, I can say, the very existence of Himalayas is a blessing. Now, all this collective negativity which goes on around the planet Earth is nullified just by the existence of Himalayas. I can tell you one thing. I can tell you with this, with honest pride, the Himalayas has created a culture, it has created a tradition, it has created a great literature based on which no terrorist group can be created. Just tell me, have you seen a single terrorist group which has got there based on Gita and the Vedas? No. They have created such a foolproof literature. No terrorist group has got their base on the Gita. It is given to a person as encouraging him to fight. See the paradox. Gita itself is delivered encouraging somebody to fight, but no terrorist group can be found under philosophy. It is given so beautifully. When somebody reads and digests, simply will be transformed. The very idea to fight or the vengeance will disappear from him. Will disappear from him. Anyhow, I can be proud of one thing. Our culture is so great. The heritage is so great. The tradition is so great. No terrorist group can have their base based on the Vedic philosophy or the Vedic teachings, Vedic life and the Vedic tradition. This great culture is created in this holy land. One more thing, just in 5 cities of India, in Himalayas, just in 5 cities, 100,000 registered ashrams exist. 100,000 monasteries. Understand? 100,000 monasteries in just 5 cities. Panjaburi Sadhu Samaj, that's what they call. Just this 5 city has got 100,000 registered ashrams. Means all other houses are just to support the ashram activities. Himalayas is for sadhus and sannyasis, the people who support their activity, they stay there, that's all. And this great holy land, whatever I speak, whatever I tell, it will be only less. We will experience it. We will experience it. One more thing, important thing. Not only we are going to see the great inner science laboratories, not only we are going to experience the great spiritual energy. See, not only this place is a laboratory, many enlightened masters have come and left their body here. Even Shankara. From Shankara, all the great enlightened masters, they come here just to leave the body. Just to leave the body. And we are not only going to see the inner science laboratories and enjoy the energy. The third important thing, we are going to live and experience a glimpse of Vedic life for next 15 days. Of course, if you have lived these 15 days intensely like rishis, you will not be same old person. You will not be the same person again. You will not be the same person again. In the Delhi railway station, there is a small Ganapati and Hanuman temple. Small Ganapati temple and Hanuman temple. Any of you have come by train, you would have seen. There is a small Ganapati and Hanuman temple. In that, near the temple only I used to sleep. That's where I slept. This Delhi railway station is the witness. For me, I slept in that railway station only. From there I started. It took, I think, more than 9.5 months. More than 9 months, less than 10 months. It took complete trip. I did by walk. Completely by walk. Yamunotri I did not go that time. But other next trip, I went to Yamunotri also by walk. Now whatever we are traveling by bus, the whole thing is traveled by me by walk. So let you understand, it is not so difficult. So hereby, I conclude it is not so difficult. Anyhow, it will actually be real fun. And one more thing, unless you live like this in some places, your foolish mind will be thinking that your whole life is under your control. It is better to see and experience and understand your life is not under your control. If you live in cities, you become so designed or pre-planned, your whole day you know your whole day routine. The moment you get up, you know, around 6:30 you are going to have fight with your wife, and 7:30 fight with the son, and 9:30 fight with your boss, office boss. And around evening 3:30, fight with your subordinates. And around again 4:30 or 5:30, again fight with your wife. And you know your whole routine, where you will go, where you will sit, where you will come back. You know the whole routine. Nothing new happens in your life. From morning, getting up from bed, till you go back to bed. You know your routine. That is why you feel bored. At the most, small accident can happen. That also insured already. There is nothing new in your life. There is nothing new at all in your life. By and by, you become so self-centered, your mind starts believing life is completely under your control. Whenever something happens which is beyond your control, you are totally shaken. Your whole being is shaken. Be very clear. Here I am giving you the first basic training and understanding life is not under your control as you think. That is the first understanding you need to have. That's the first understanding you need to have. That will prepare you for the unexpected incidents in your life. Every one of you are going to face unexpected incidents. Your death is the first unexpected incident. Any of you are here? No, I am not going to die, Swamiji. Even though you think and strongly believe, it is not going to happen. Let it be clear. Let me tell you, all of us, not only you, I am also going to die. Let us be very clear, which we may not expect, which we may not predict, which we may not be even able to imagine. Traveling in Himalayas, living in Himalayas will prepare you to face your life. Things happen in unexpected way. I can say the first basic quality to live an exciting life is ready to face the unexpected things in your life. Spiritual life is nothing but high intelligence and high intense passion to live. Intense excitement and passion and intelligence is what I call spiritual life. These two, intelligence and intense passion to live. Intense excitement and energy to live in unexpected way, and intelligence to face the unexpected things is spirituality.